Her name is Allison Pasco. She's an SU student. student. And just recently, I gotta say this, she was selected as a VPA scholar. So she is one of 12 students in her college at Syracuse University. It is a huge honor to be selected as a VPA scholar, and we have been so lucky to work with her in the past 7 weeks. All right, so this is a tap of the welcome.
Oh, that's the same.
actually going to require your help. So it's Music in Our Schools Month, but it's also March Madness. So I want you to imagine that we are an awesome NCAA basketball game, okay? Sadly, it's not in the dome. Sadly, not this year. All right, on the screens, you're going to see cues for our chant, for our cheers. Our first one, the cheer is, let's go Lanigan, let's go Lanigan. So when I turn around, I need you to pretend you are in the stand, you are gonna rock them, I need screaming, okay? Let's pump it up.
Great job. We're lucky to have her. We're lucky to have the program we do. I see some of our drummers are walking out here now to share their God-given instruments with you. And the Lanigan chorus, everyone. Give them a hand.
Hi, my name is Sullivan. Our first song is from the Katanga province in southern Congo. The language you will hear is called Kilumba. It is a silly folk song, and the meaning of the words are: at the foot of the banana, of the pineapple tree, Yaku put a banana in his aunt's red hat. Enjoy.
Sí. name is Ariana. Our next song is from the movie musical, The Greatest Showman. It is a beautiful song that speaks of hopes and dreams.
Olivia Rodriguez, Brooke McNamara, Vita Galini, Chloe Merritt, Hayla Patriot, Chase Alapa, and Jamie Chappelle. Let's give them a round of applause.
For their children, but are your child's extracurricular activities having the lasting impact you're hoping for? Maybe it's time to consider music for your child. Music education during childhood has been shown to have a multitude of benefits. It sharpens students' attentiveness, abstract reasoning, and creativity. Children who are musically trained have stronger everyday listening and memory skills. In addition, music engages both sides of the brain and challenges children to simultaneously concentrate on multiple tasks. Music and math are highly intertwined. By understanding beats, rhythm, and scales, even the youngest music makers are learning how to divide, create fractions, and recognize patterns. Music also helps children develop coordination and motor skills, as well as self-discipline and self-esteem. Students who participate in music programs consistently score higher in mathematics and English than their peers. Studies have also shown that individuals who took music lessons as children often show stronger neural processing of sound, even up to 50 years later. Making the decision to enroll your child in a music class is a no-brainer. Parents, build your child's cognitive and emotional development and give them the gift of music. To learn more about the benefits of making music at every stage of life, visit namfoundation.org.
Everybody. So this month is Music in Our Schools Month. It is known from NENC or NAFME. It's our National Music Association that is through New York State and through all of the United States. They have decided that March is the month to celebrate our music groups. I particularly am very fond of all the music groups that we have in our district, but they also have other groups around the world that continue to celebrate Music in Our Schools Month, as well as not just our orchestras and bands and choirs, but everywhere. The first song that you heard was our Twinkle. The kids actually just got Twinkle because we started working from our Suzuki books probably, what, about 3 weeks ago? So they've had like 3 lessons on it. So they did an awesome job. And if you notice, our cellos, violas, and basses were playing on their D and A strings, and all of our violins, they just learned all their E string notes for the first time. So they were practicing their A and E string notes. So I was very happy to hear them play Twinkle. Can we give them another round? The next piece that we are going to play for you is called Power Rock, and I actually have a couple students that are going to be playing tambourine. Actually, just one today. It's Malachi. The orchestra is going to play for you is called Tuna Rumble, and we actually have Mrs. Sweet playing the piano solo for it. There's a very cool jazzy piano part that she offered to play for us tonight, so thank you, Mrs. Sweet. One quick note, I did leave some permission slips on our table outside of the auditorium for all of the orchestra students. The Syracuse Crunch, at the very beginning of the year, asked me if we could come and perform the National Anthem or American Beautiful, or just come and perform for the Syracuse Crunch before the game. I've done it at all of my other schools that I've done it with, and this year we've decided to turn it into a string night. So it's going to be for all of the elementary schools, the junior high kids, and the senior high kids. I am asking that if you do decide to go, that you would bring your child to the Syracuse Crunch. They would perform before the game, and then we would also do the national anthem. The kids would sit all together, and we would have a great time. It's so much fun to go. I do need the permission slip back, but you can purchase tickets for yourself on their website. There's an email, or there's a phone number that you can call. Every performer is free, so the kids get in for free. There is no cost to them. But they do need an adult with them if they're going to go. It is an optional concert. It is April 23rd, but all of the information is in the back. And if you have other questions after the concert, feel free to come up and chat with me, because I'd be more than happy to have a conversation with anyone. All right.
So our last piece is called Tuna Rumble.